Good evening, students. Let us today start with the next topic called current commutation. In this method, a current flowing opposite to the direction of the SCR or thyristor current is used to turn off the thyristor. We can see the circuit diagram of current commutation, or this is also called resonance commutation. This circuit is used for current commutation. Here, a capacitor, you can see it is connected with an inductor in a small circuit across the thyristor, and a DC source VDC is used along with the load in series. Now, the capacitor C is charged externally in the polarity as shown in the figure, with lower plate positive, upper plate negative. When switch S is closed, the thyristor TH1 is already in conduction mode. The capacitor will try to discharge through the path C, L, TH and C. This way, the current IC will flow just opposite to the flow of current through thyristor or the load current. So, at an instant, when IC is equal to IL, thyristor is forcefully turned off. This is called forced commutation. The maximum value of IC is given by IC max equal to V upon LC, where V is the voltage, L is inductance, C is capacitance, at time T is equal to T1. When IC is equal to IL, thyristor is turned off. Now let us see the waveforms of this circuit. Here, two levels are shown, plus VDC and minus VDC. This one is the capacitor voltage, VC. The voltage across capacitor is equal to minus VDC. It is charged externally. At time T is equal to T1, when the current through the thyristor, IT, is equal to the current through the capacitor, at this particular instant, the thyristor is turned off forcefully due to current commutation. Okay, so these are the waveforms of resonance commutation or current commutation circuit. Thank you so much for attending my lecture. Share it with your friends also. Thanks.